The Audio Partners Publishing Corporation is pleased to present Mark Twain's Library of Humor, an anthology of stories selected by Mark Twain himself, originally published in 1888. The readers are Marsh McCandless, Richard Russ, Rich Nicholas, and Marni Webb.
The Notorious Jumping Frog of Calaveras County by Mark Twain. Read by Marsh McCandless.
In compliance with the request of a friend of mine who wrote me from the East, I called on good-natured, garrulous old Simon Wheeler and inquired after my friend's friend, Leonidas W. Smiley, as requested to do, and I hereunto append the result. I have a lurking suspicion that Leonidas W. Smiley is a myth, that my friend never knew such a personage, and that he only conjectured that if I asked old Wheeler about him, it would remind him of his infamous Jim Smiley, and he would go to work and bore me to death with some exasperating reminiscence of him, as long and as tedious as it should be useless to me. Well, if that was the design, it succeeded. I found Simon Wheeler dozing comfortably by the barroom stove of the dilapidated tavern in the decayed mining camp of Angels, and I noticed that he was fat and bald-headed, and had an expression of winning gentleness and simplicity upon his tranquil countenance. He roused up and gave me good day. I told him a friend of mine had commissioned me to make some inquiries about a cherished companion of his boyhood, named Leonidas W. Smiley. Reverend Leonidas W. Smiley, a young minister of the gospel, who he had heard was at one time a resident of Angel's Camp. I added that if Mr. Wheeler could tell me anything about this Reverend Leonidas W. Smiley, I would feel under many obligations to him. Simon Wheeler backed me into a corner and blockaded me there with his chair, then sat down and reeled off the monotonous narrative which follows this paragraph. He never smiled. He never frowned. He never changed his voice from the gentle flowing key to which he tuned his initial sentence. He never betrayed the slightest suspicion of enthusiasm. But all through the interminable narrative, there ran a vein of impressive earnestness and sincerity, which showed me plainly that, so far from his imagining that there was anything ridiculous or funny about his story, he regarded it as a really important matter, and admired its two heroes as men of transcendent genius in finesse. I let him go on in his own way, and never interrupted him once. Reverend Leonidas W. Reverend Lee. Well, there was a fella here once by the name of Jim Smiley in the winter of 49, or maybe it was the spring of 50. I don't recollect exactly somehow, though what makes me think it was one or the other is because I remember the big flume warn't finished when he first come to camp. But anyway, he was the curiousest man about, always betting on anything that turned up you ever see, if he could get anybody to bet on the other side, and if he couldn't, he'd change sides. Any way that suited the other side would suit him. Anyway, just so's he got a bet, he was satisfied. But still he was lucky, uncommon lucky. He most always come out winner. He was always ready and laying for a chance. There couldn't be no solitary thing mentioned but that fella'd offer to bet on it, and take every side you please, as I was just telling you. If there was a horse race, you'd find him flush, or you'd find him busted at the end of it. If there was a dog fight, he'd bet on it. If there was a cat fight, he'd bet on it. If there was a chicken fight, he'd bet on it. Why, if there was two birds setting on a fence, he'd bet you which one would fly first. Or if there was a camp meeting, he'd be there regular.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.